But the problem doesn't stop there. Metadata is overloaded, but my video has gotten popular. And so all of these guys want to download the content from me, which means that everybody is coming to me, and I have an itsy bitsy server in my basement, and that is going to get inundated with all of these download requests from all of these different clients that want to get this video from me. So there is a metadata overload, and there is a content overload that is coming about because of the fact that something became really hot and everybody wants to get that content. And this is what is called the origin server overload. In general, there are two solutions to the origin server overload problem. The first solution is to have a web proxy. And you might be familiar with this already because every organization tends to have a web proxy so that they can limit the amount of requests that have to go out of an organization. And that way, if users of an organization are trying to access popular content from the internet, the local web proxy that's available in the organization can directly serve that content to the requesters. But it turns out that the web proxy solution is not good enough for what is called a slash dart effect. And that is, if there is a breaking news and everyone wants to get the content, they will have to get the fresh content. Proxy is not good enough for that. Let's say that there's a Super Bowl going on and everybody wants to watch the Super Bowl or at least get latest updates from that. In that case, the web proxy is not going to be good because the content in the web proxy is a cached content. You want the live content. And the live content is only available at the origin server, not at the proxies, and therefore the origin server will get overloaded when we have such dynamic content, a content that is resulting from either breaking news or live programming and so on. And this is where the content distribution networks come into play. The idea is that the content is automatically mirrored from the origin server at selected geographical locations. And those locations are constantly getting updated from the origin server so that going to any of the mirrored content is the same as going to the origin server. And then what happens is that in the content distribution network, depending on the geographical area from which a particular user request originates, the user request is dynamically rerouted to the geo-local mirror of the content so that the origin server need not be overloaded. You may be familiar with companies like Akamai, which have come about for the purposes of providing content distribution network for popular content providers like CNN or broadcast television channels like CBS, NBC, and so on. And what these organizations, that is the content providers, do is get into an agreement with a content distribution network provider like Akamai so that they don't have to worry about origin server overload because the content distribution network provider like Akamai have the solution for taking the content at the origin and automatically mirroring it in geolocal sites so that the origin server never gets overloaded. Now, this is good if you are a big organization like CNN or CBS. You can afford to pay the content distribution network provider to do this automatic mirroring. But how can we democratize content distribution? How am I in my basement generating a piece of video and I want to share it with the world? How am I going to make that available to everybody? If it gets hot, I don't want to get overloaded. I want that content distribution network to work without having to pay big bucks to a content distribution network provider like Akamai. And this is where the Coral system comes in. This is the paper that I've assigned you to read, which has a technique for democratizing content distribution. And the details of the Coral system is what we're going to look at next. So the Coral system addresses two issues. The first issue is the fact that if I generate some content and I want to store the key value pair associated with the content in a DHT, I have to have a scalable way of doing it without saturating any particular node which can serve as a metadata server. So we want to avoid the tree saturation effect. And the second thing that we want to do is also avoid the origin server overload. So both of those things are being addressed in providing a democratic solution for content distribution for the average Joe that may want to generate some content and want to share it with the rest of the world. We will look at the details of the Codal system in the rest of this lecture.